Mount Sinai is the first place in the world to successfully transplant human trachea. It's really more than unique and more than incredible. It's shy of a miracle.
If I wouldn't have the transplant, the doctor told me that I had 1 to 3 months to live because I was going to suffocate. I said, wow, we would have been planning a funeral.
Sonia came to me probably 5 or 6 years ago, and she had been intubated for an asthma attack, and they damaged her airway pretty severely. She had had 4 or 5 surgeries to try to reconstruct it. Each time they chip away and cause damage to more and more of the trachea. In order for her to maintain an airway, she had to keep a long segment tracheostomy in. They're very dangerous, and if they fall out, she suffocates. And she got to a point where it was such a difficult thing for her that she eventually said, if you can't do something for me, it's not worth it for me to live.
I told him, all I want is 5 minutes. That's all he can give me, 5 minutes of being able to breathe. It took a lot for me to go into that surgery. I was nervous, I was scared, but I had to think about seeing my granddaughter being able to breathe.
This was a concept that started as a student at Mount Sinai 30 years ago, based off of a patient that died because we had no way to reconstruct a trachea after removing a tumor. And to take that from a concept, just an idea, and bring it into the laboratory, do the basic science, to actually bring this to the clinic, to the patient, to Sonia, is an incredible thing. Along the way, there were tremendous hurdles that had to be overcome. The general scientific dogma that you could not transplant a trachea. There was no way to revascularize it. I think what we've proven is that this can be done.
We agreed that when an appropriate donor came about, that we would transfer that donor here to Mount Sinai for the procurement. That takes a lot of coordinated effort, and there are very few places that can pull that off. Nobody has done the trachea, so the way it's taken out often has just as much importance as the way it's put in.
The segment of the operation where you're putting the organ into the recipient, that's really a game time decision. There's no way to actually practice that. The team worked very quickly to get the graft in and then revascularize it. We have to hook up the arteries, which bring the blood to the graft, and the vein, which deliver the blood out from the graft. When you take a look at the graft and you realize it's working, you realize that this was just an idea and it was a dream, and lo and behold, you know, it actually is working. It's a pretty satisfying moment. It's pretty amazing, actually.
I'm able to dance with my grandkids for the first time of 6 years. So that's the best thing that this transplant had given me, is to be able to do those little things, playing with them and just having a good time. And laughing. I haven't done that in a long time.
I'm feeling really delighted for Sonia. She's progressed probably better than we could have ever expected. Whenever you have a first time in human surgery that's going to truly impact hundreds, thousands of lives, it's very special. It'll be very interesting to see how we move forward to try to help a large number of patients that up to this point had no option.
I want the next person that gets into that surgery to know there is hope.